Adding packages to your Zammad installation to extend its features or change its appearance in a packaged way is straightforward. I will show you the options you have and point out possible limitations down the road. Please note that the information shown here do not apply to Zammad hosted environments. If you want to use packages with Docker Compose, you will have to build your own Zammad container with the changes packed already. This is due to how Docker containers are designed. The examples I'm providing in this video are based on a Debian 11 package installation. Source code installation should barely differ from comments. Let's dive into it. Packages are a great way to extend Zammad with further features or adjustments that are not available in Zammad's core. That being said, it does not matter if you get a custom development from Zammad directly or build your own package. There are also community members that already wrote packages which may be a good addition for you as well. I will leave a link to the Zammad community that will show packages that have been posted there by members. Please keep in mind that community packages have not been qualified by Zammad. This means that any bug or other potential issues they cause are not covered by any support contract or eligible for bug reports on Zammad's repository. Some packages may have version dependencies because Zammad's core may have changed. Keep this in mind and, if in doubt, check with the author of the package. Also, depending on the functionalities your package adds, further gems might be required. This should be noted in the package's README and is not reflected in this video, because my demo package does not contain this use case. If you have such a use case, do the following. After installing the package, but before running the migrations, execute zammad config z bundle underscore deployment equals 0. Followed by zammad run bundle config z minus minus local deployment false. Now run zammad run bundle install to install all missing gems. Continue with the other steps I'm going to mention later. You have three options on how to install Zammad packages. They depend on your installation type and the options you have. Packages that require asset recompilation will not work with stock Docker images of Zammad due to missing dependencies. Adding packages is not something you can do entirely via UI. However, for most, at least the uploading packages part surely is easier than the console approach. To add new packages to Zammad, simply log in as an administrator and go to Packages within the admin menu. Select the package file you want to install and then use the Install Package button to upload the package. At this stage, you will have to switch to the console of your Zammad installation. Run zammad run rake zammad package migrate to execute possible available package database migrations. If the package in question changes or adds visual things like style sheets or UI components, also make sure to run zammad run rake assets pre-compile. This should be required for most of the packages. After the precompile finished, restart Zammad and reload the session in your web browser. The demo package I've installed changes the Zammad Phoenix to this channel's logo and is just a very simple example to show you. Before you can install the package, you will need to upload it to your Zammad server. The easiest approach to do so is using SCP for this. The directory you write these files to does not matter, as long as the Zammad user is able to read the files in question. Now you can tell Zammad where to find the package file by using package install file passed to your package file in Zammad Rails console. Run zammad run rake zammad package migrate to execute possible available package database migrations. If the package in question changes or adds visual things like style sheets or UI components, also make sure to run zammad run rake assets pre-compile. This should be required for most of the packages. After the pre-compile finished, restart zammad and reload the session in your web browser. The demo package I've installed changes the Zammad Phoenix to this channel's logo and is just a very simple example to show you. The third option only works during the installation of Zammad. It requires you to have a auto_install directory in your Zammad directory before the database is being seeded. This most likely is only interesting for source code installations, because you have the most control over the installation steps. Zammad will automatically attempt to install all ZVM packages that you provided in said directory. Technically, you can also run package auto_install manually after the installation of Zammad. Note that this is not suitable for update scenarios and thus only works once. This method does not reduce your workload, as you still have to run the migrations and precompile. A fourth method is package linking. This is rather useful for development reasons. Unlike finished packages, you only need the repository code and the source ZVM file. I'm only mentioning this for completeness reasons. Run package link path to the repository to add the repository directory to your Zammad installation. You can revert this by using package unlink path to the repository. You will still need to run the package migrations and pre-compile process. When having packages installed to Zammad, the update process slightly changes. Most of these required steps are automatically handled by the package installation since Zammad 6 for you. If you're not using a package installation, run the commands I mentioned in order and you should be good as well. Before updating, make sure to upload your new package file. For this, use any of the methods we've talked about earlier, like UI or console. This is mandatory to ensure compatibility in case code APIs have changed in a future release. Now you can follow the update process as usual by stopping Zammad, clearing its cache and updating. Now here's what's happening in a package update in terms of packages. Before writing the new core files, Zammad run rake Zammad package uninstall all files is being run. This ensures that there's no custom files blocking the upgrade process for whatever reason. Substitute Zammad run from the command for source code based installations. After writing the core files, updating the database and translations, the package files are reinstalled by using Zammad run rake Zammad package reinstall all. In case any of your packages uses gem files to add further gems, the following commands are run as well. Zammad config z bundle underscore deployment 0, Zammad run bundle config z --- local deployment false, and Zammad run bundle install. Last but not least, Zammad run rake Zammad package migrate and Zammad run rake assets precompiler run to finish the package update. You see, there's not much to do additionally during an update. Of course, you can also remove existing packages. Usually you want to do this when a functionality has come to Zammad's core or when you no longer need the function it provides. If the installed package changes source code files that exist in Zammad's core, Zammad automatically creates a save file. For this reason, it's safe to remove packages at any time code-wise. Keep in mind that database tables and thus information stored by the package will be removed from the database. Proceed with caution. Removing is quickly done. Simply navigate to Packages in the admin menu and click on Uninstall for the package of your choice. You can also do this in your Rails console. Within Zammad run Rails C, run package plug name version to list all packages with their versions. Now you can run package uninstall name of your package and version with the version of your package. This will remove all packages, files and restore original source code files if applicable. Now run Zammad run rake Zammad package migrate, followed by Zammad run rake assets precompile and a restart of Zammad. I hope this gave you a brief overview on how to install packages and update Zammad with them. If this video helped, please consider liking and subscribe to my channel. This helps me to see if I should make more content on these topics. Until next time, take care.